My name is Libero Ligieri. I'm from the National Research Council in Italy. I'm the PI, that means the coordinator, principal investigator for the PAST experiment, a project that is funded by ESA. The aim of this experiment is essentially the study of the destabilization of emulsions. Essentially, an emulsion is a mixture of an oil with water. And everybody knows that if you mix water with oil at a given time, they will separate. In order to avoid that, there are additives that are added to these products, and these products makes the emulsion stable, so do not separate. The mayonnaise, for example, do not separate in oil and the water phase. The possibility to control products for the daily life use, like foods, like kind of detergents, cosmetics, and so on. The aim is to study, in particular, the way in which these products can be made more stable in time, and allow that with the minimal amount of additives in some way. The idea is then that we can produce these foods and cosmetics and detergents and products for the petrochemical industry, for example, in a way that is greener and with less impact for the environment and also for the health. So why microgravity? And it is because the key to understand why these particles separate is to understand exactly the interaction between the droplets. And under microgravity, of course, we don't have this disturbing effect of the droplets that are moving and separating because of the gravity. And we have a better view on the action of this mechanism. The experiment itself will last for about 4 months under microgravity conditions, and we expect that we could analyze the results within 1 year about from the end of the experiment. In this initial stage, for about a week, we will follow the experiments directly here from Brussels in order to, to have a better interaction and a quicker interaction with the BUSOC and with the people who are responsible for the control of the experiment here. This is actually not new for me. This I participated in too many previous experiments in both on the Space Shuttle and on the International Space Station. But of course, it is always exciting and it's quite thrilling anyway.